subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Johnson. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 13th of October. Indian Prime Minister Modi unveils Gati Shakti National Master Plan to boost infrastructure development. No rift between PM Khan and Army over spy chief's appointment, says Pakistani minister. And G20 pledges efforts to avert Afghanistan humanitarian crisis. And now for all the details. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Wednesday launched the PM Gati Shakti National Master Plan for multimodal connectivity to economic zones in the country that aims to develop infrastructure to reduce logistic costs and boost the economy. PM said the program will boost India's self-confidence and make the country self-reliant.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Wednesday launched the ambitious $1.35 trillion Gati Shakti Master Plan to provide multimodal connectivity to more than 1,200 industrial clusters, including two defence corridors across the country. The plan aims to lend more power and speed to projects by connecting all concerned departments on one platform, PM said, adding the infrastructure schemes of various ministries and state governments will be designed and executed with a common vision. This will create the foundation of India for the next 25 years, he added.
Ye national master plan 21st sadi ke Bharat ko गति शक्ति देगा नेक्स्ट जनरेशन इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर और मल्टी मॉडल कनेक्टिविटी को इस नेशनल प्लान से गति शक्ति मिलेगी इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर से जुड़ी सरकारी नीतियों में प्लानिंग से लेकर एग्जीक्यूशन तक को ये नेशनल प्लान गति शक्ति देगा।
The plan is an important part of Prime Minister Modi's Atmanirbhar Bharat, self-dependent India vision and ambitiously aims to lend more power and speed to projects under national infrastructure pipeline and boost the economy.
Amid growing cross-border terror threats, India at the SECA meet in Kazakhstan on Tuesday delivered a strong message to Pakistan by pointing out that cross-border terrorism is not statecraft. It is simply another form of terrorism. India called upon the international community to unite against this evil as seriously as it does on issues like climate change and pandemics. Indian Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar spoke of terrorism as a major challenge facing the region at the sixth meeting of the foreign ministers of the SECA, Conference of Interaction and Confidence Building Measures in Asia, in Kazakhstan on Tuesday. In a message to Pakistan without naming it, Jaishankar said cross-border terrorism is not statecraft but simply another form of the menace, as it called upon the international community to unite against this evil as seriously as it does on issues like climate change and pandemics.
If peace and development is our common goal, the biggest enemy we must overcome is terrorism. In this day and age, we cannot countenance its use by one state against another. Cross-border terrorism is not statecraft. It is simply another form of terrorism.
Amid China's aggressive behavior in the Indo-Pacific region and ambitious infrastructure development plans in Pakistan under the CPEC, China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, Jaishankar asserted that connectivity must respect the most basic principle of international relations, respect for sovereignty and territorial integrity. New Delhi has protested to Beijing over the CPEC as it is being laid through Pakistan-administered Kashmir. In news from Pakistan, The Pakistan government has maintained that there is no conflict between Prime Minister Imran Khan and Army Chief General Qamar Javed Bajwa over the recent appointment of Chief of Spy Agency ISI. No relevant notification was issued by the PM's office, which led to renewed speculations about a conflict between the civilian government and the army.
There were no differences between Prime Minister Imran Khan and Army Chief General Qamar Javed Bajwa over the appointment of the new Chief of Spy Agency ISI, the Inter-Services Intelligence, Pakistan's Information Minister Fawad Chaudhry said on Wednesday, adding that all institutions are united and equal. In a tweet, Chaudhry said consultations between the Prime Minister and the Army Chief have been completed and the process for the new appointment has begun. The Pakistan Army had last week announced that Lieutenant General Nadeem Ahmed Anjum was appointed as new ISI Chief in place of Lieutenant General Faiz Hamid. However, a notification of the appointment was not issued by the PM's office, giving credence to rumours about differences over the key appointment. Reports suggest PM Khan wants Faiz Hamid to continue on the post for some more time in view of the Afghanistan situation. Several opposition leaders, including senior leader of PMLN party and former Prime Minister Shahid Khaqan Abbasi, had also raised the issue, saying the civil leadership should not interfere in routine transfer and postings of the military. Reports suggest, as per law, the Prime Minister has the legal right to appoint the ISI chief in consultation with the Army chief.
More news from Pakistan. Specially abled persons recently held a protest in Pakistan's Lahore city to demand jobs and blame the establishment for ignoring them despite having proper qualifications. They lamented Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan has failed to fulfill his promises of providing millions of jobs.
Rising unemployment continues to be a primary concern of locals and educated youths across Pakistan. Specially abled persons recently held a protest in Pakistan's Lahore city to demand jobs amid the COVID-19 pandemic and appealed Prime Minister Imran Khan-led government to fulfill its promises of providing employment. The protesters, mostly visually impaired, claimed that despite having proper qualifications, the government is hardly bothered about them and warned that they will continue to protest until their voices are heard.
इस धरने की वजह ये है कि जितने भी नवीन अफराद मुजाहरा कर रहे हैं उनको जॉब्स चाहिए हुकूमत से क्योंकि तमाम जो नवीन अफराद हैं वो पढ़े लिखे हैं लेकिन उनकी तालीम के मुताबिक उनको जॉब्स नहीं मिली तो ये इसी तरह धरना जारी रहेगा
हमें यही है हम पढ़े लिखे लोग हैं हम कोई भीख नहीं मांग रहे हम जिस जो हमारी क्वालिफिकेशन है उसके मुताबिक हमें नौकरी दी जाए
Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan had promised to provide 10 million jobs over the next 5 years when he came into power in 2018. However, recent unemployment data released by the Pakistan Institute of Development Economics shows that 24% of people who have at least an undergraduate degree are without a job in the country.
The group of 20 major economies pledged efforts to help tackle the humanitarian crisis in Afghanistan during a virtual meeting on Tuesday. The world leaders, however, stressed this does not mean formal recognition to the Taliban-led government. Since the Islamic Emirate took control, Afghanistan is facing an economic collapse as most of the international assistance has been cut off and billions of dollars in central bank assets abroad have also been frozen.
The group of 20 major economies pledged efforts to help tackle the humanitarian crisis in Afghanistan, even if it means having to coordinate efforts with the Taliban. This, however, does not mean formal recognition, Italian Prime Minister Mario Draghi said on Tuesday after hosting the G20 Extraordinary Summit on Afghanistan virtually. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi during the meeting underscored the need to ensure that Afghan soil does not become a source of radicalization and terrorism. 2 months after the Taliban took control in Afghanistan, the country is facing an economic collapse as banks are running out of money and food prices have soared, while most of the nation's international assistance has been cut off and billions of dollars in central bank assets held abroad have also been frozen. Meanwhile, U.S. State Department spokesperson Ned Price said on Tuesday that earlier this past weekend, a delegation of the US and the Taliban representatives held productive discussions in Doha on the issue of humanitarian assistance. He informed that the US side reiterated that the Taliban would be judged on their actions, not just their words.
In a bid to discourage women from defecating in open, local administration in India's central Bhopal city organized a unique race, Lota Daur competition, or run with a water pot to raise awareness about open defecation among the people. The race witnessed active participation from women who were seen carrying water pots in their hands. Women in Bhopal city of India's central Madhya Pradesh state participated in a unique race called Lota Daur competition or run with a water pot to discourage open defecation. Over a dozen mothers-in-law enthusiastically on Tuesday took part in the competition organized by the local administration to spread the message of consequences of open defecation and what to stop the malpractice. All the mothers-in-law through their participation endeavored to discourage their daughters-in-law from going through the same problems they faced due to the lack of toilets.
इसमें हम सभी बहुओं को बल्कि सारे समाज को एक मैसेज दे रहे हैं कि जो सासों ने सहन किया जो एक ऐसी प्रथा थी कि घर से बाहर लोटा लेकर हमें जाना ही पड़ेगा तो अब इस कुप्रथा को समझ लीजिए खत्म कर दिया हम लोगों ने हम लोटा लेकर सासे जो जा चुकी जो सहन कर चुकी अब बहुओं को ये सब नहीं करना पड़ेगा
एवरी मॉर्निंग अराउंड डॉन हंड्रेड्स ऑफ पीपल इंक्लूडिंग वुमेन स्टिल गैदर्ड बाय द डस्टी बैंक्स ऑफ वाटर बॉडीज और फील्ड्स इन इंडिया टू डिफिकेट इन द ओपन Studies link open defecation to public health issues as it increases the spread of parasites due to the water contamination. Prime Minister Narendra Modi's government in 2014 launched the Swachh Bharat Mission, a flagship scheme to eradicate open defecation and ensure management of solid waste in all statutory towns. The 90th festival of Navratri is at its crescendo with singing, dancing and praying, all being part of the huge celebration. Hindu devotees across India on Wednesday thronged temples to offer prayers to Goddess Durga on the occasion of Durgashtami, the 8th day of the religious festival.
Devotees across India on Wednesday thronged temples to offer prayers on the auspicious Durgashtami, the 8th day of the Hindu festival of Navratri or Nine Nights. The Navratri festival is dedicated to Goddess Durga and her various incarnations and is also called Durga Puja in eastern parts of India. Devotees observe fast during this period and perform rituals and sing hymns to please the goddess.
देखिए कोरोना काल की वजह से बहुत ही लोगों को नुकसान पहुंचे वगैरह मगर देवी मां के आशीर्वाद से सब कुछ चल गया सब कुछ ठीक हो गया.
Meanwhile, in India's northeastern state of Tripura, devotees worshipped a young girl who was dressed as the goddess Durga to mark the occasion, which is also known as Maha Ashtami.
सब माँ का अलग अलग रूप होते हैं तो इस जगत में पूजा का मेन तत्व जो है जो नारी जाति को सम्मान करना चाहिए और ऋषि लोग ने ये बोला जो जीवन में कुछ करना है तो मातृ जाति को सम्मान करो
Meanwhile, in India's western Gujarat state, people donned protective suits as part of their dancing gear to generate awareness about the spread of the coronavirus while performing Garba, a traditional dance performed during the 9-day festive period. Navratri culminates on the 10th day, which is celebrated as Dashera.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude the top stories once again. Indian Prime Minister Modi unveils Gati Shakti National Master Plan to boost infrastructure development. No rift between PM Khan and Army over spy chief's appointment, says Pakistani minister. And G20 pledges efforts to avert Afghanistan humanitarian crisis. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. breaking news and views from India.